Good morning. My name is Komal Kumar and I am an assistant professor in the department of ECE. So today I will be explaining about regulated power supply with this block diagram and its brief review how the applications are being used and the respective procedure. So the basic regulated power supply device. The main operation of this regulated power supply is to convert an AC signal into a complete DC signal. So what are the blocks used in this particular device are So this is the general block diagram representation of a regulated power supply. It consists of four different blocks. One is the transformer block, the second one is the rectifier block, the third is the filter block, and last is the regulator block. So each and every block has its own different operation for converting the AC signal into a complete DC signal. So before getting onto the details of these blocks, let me represent a graphical representation how each and every block convert the AC signal into DC signal. So first, when you are applying an AC signal, this is our AC signal, which is considered an example of a sinusoidal waveform. Now we will see how each and every block will convert this particular AC signal into a complete DC signal. So at first, when we are giving it to a transformer is a device where it can decrease the voltage as well as increase the voltage of a particular signal. So here, the transformer is again classified into two basic classifications. One is a step-up transformer. Another one is a step-down transformer. Here, a step-up transformer increases the voltage of the input signal so that the output signal will be a very high voltage. So consider, for example, we have a 10 volt input signal given to a step-up transformer. It can increase that particular 10 volts into 100 volts, 300 volts, etc. So that is the basic operation of a step-up transformer. And coming to the step-down transformer, here the transformer decreases the voltage signal of the input signal. So for example, if you consider a 200 volt input supply, that can be decreased to around 5, 10, 15, 20, etc. So these are the two operations of the transformer. So as for this regulated supply, we will be using a step-down transformer because most of the electronic device will be operating in a low power supply mode. So that's why we will be using a step-down transformer to apply this particular device for an electronic device. Now, as for the step-down operation, this particular signal voltage will be decreased in this particular first step. Considering the graphical representation, so it will be having a low voltage signal compared to the input signal. Right, so this is your input signal. When given to a step down transformer, the voltage level of the graphical representation is little less. Now, when this particular signal is given to a rectifier, so the rectifier main operation is to convert the AC signal into a pulsating DC mode. That is, we are not converting the complete signal into a DC form. We are only reducing some portions of your AC signal so that in the later steps we can convert that particular signal into a complete DC. So we'll see the approximate graphical representation is So this is your output signal of a rectifier. So here we have a positive cycle as well as negative cycle when we are obtaining an AC signal. But when this particular signal is given to a rectifier, it is converting into one of its portions. That is, in this particular graph, you only see the positive cycles and all the negative cycles are being eliminated. So for that, we will be having three more classifications for the rectifier. So we have a half wave rectifier, a full wave rectifier, and a bridge wave rectifier. So these are the three classifications of the rectifier where we can convert the AC signal into a pulsating DC. So it is converting the AC signal into a pulsating DC, but the basic disadvantage of the rectifier is the ripples present in this particular signal are very, very high. That is, when you compare this particular graph to a DC signal, so this is a DC signal graph. Right. So when you compare these two graphs, here the ripples are much more compared to this particular DC signal. So this is our last outcome for this particular device. So again, we are connecting this particular signal to a filter circuit such that the particular ripples can be as reduced as possible. So the approximate output of a filter circuit is when pulsating DC signal is given to a filter device, this filter device converts this pulsating DC into, it is also a pulsating DC signal, but the main difference is the ripples present in this particular signal are very much filtered or attenuated in this particular signal. So these are the complete ripples produced by the rectifier. So this particular ripple is being reduced to this. Right. So for this particular operation, we are reclassifying the filters into different types. So we have a C filter, L filter, LC filter, CLC filter, and we also have a pi filter. Right. So these are the different classifications of a filter circuit where the pulsating DC signal is converted into one more pulsating DC signal, but where the ripples are being reduced as much as possible. And finally, when the low ripple signal is given to a regulator, here this particular signal will be converted totally into a DC signal. Right? So when the filter output is given to a regulator, this particular signal will be completely converted into a pure DC signal. So whereas the classification of a regulator, we have two types. One is a series regulator and other is your shunt regulator. So in the regulator, you will be comparing with an external voltage supply, so that the based on the output obtained by the external source, the ripples are being reduced as much as possible. So reading up to the overview of this particular signal, here it is basically classified into four different blocks: a transformer block, rectifier block, filter block, as well as a regulator block. Where at first the AC signal is given to a transformer, where the transformer is again classified into two different types: a step-up transformer as well as a step-down transformer. So the main operation is to decrease the voltage level of the AC signal. So here the voltage level of the input signal is being decreased as much as possible. Right? After decreasing the voltage level, it is given to a rectifier block, where the rectifier is a device which converts AC signal into a pulsating DC. So again, we have three classifications: half wave rectifier circuit, a full wave rectifier circuit, a bridge wave rectifier circuit. So using these particular classifications, the AC signal is being converted into a pulsating DC, but with very high winds. That is the only disadvantage by this rectifier cycle. It is eliminating one of the portion of the signal, but the complete ripples are being not reduced in this rectifier device. Coming to the next device, we have a filter device where the ripples produced by the rectifier is being reduced as much as possible, so that in the later process the ripples are being completely eliminated, so the signal produced will be of a pure DC signal. So here this signal is given to a filter device where the ripples are being very less compared to the input signal. So coming to the classifications, we have these many filters: C filter, L filter, LC filter, CLC filter, as well as I filter. We can use different types of filters depending upon your application. So these parameters, the capacitor as well as the inductor, will be increased if you want to have a pure DC signal at this particular step. Right? So when you increase any number of these particular parameters, the filtration process will be as more as possible. Then finally, the signal which is of less ripples given to a regulator, it has a classification of a series regulator as well as a shunt regulator. So here we'll be having a local voltage supply given to a regulator. So that local voltage supply will be monitoring the signal. That is, it compares the high voltage of the signal, and if that for example, it will take a threshold voltage, that local voltage supply will be giving the threshold voltage, such that when the input signal is less than that particular voltage, it will be the local voltage supply will be providing its voltage to the output, so that the voltage will not be dropped at any particular time. That is the main operation of a regulator. So such that the output of this particular regulator will be a pure DC signal. The applications of this regulated power supply will be given for all the electronic devices. So whatever the electronic devices which are being used, either your home appliances or your industrial appliances, all these particular devices should be needed with this particular regulated supply, because the circuit, the input provided to any of the electronic device will be of an AC signal, but the electronic device will be working on a DC signal. So this is the main block which is to be added to every electronic device. So as for this particular explanation, we have said we have the classification of step-up transformers, step-down transformers, rectifiers, filters, and regulators. Then we get on to the internal details of the rectifiers or as filters. The main rectifier topic. As a classified rectifier is classified into three basic types: a halfway rectifier, a fullway rectifier, as well as a bridge rectifier. So let me take an example circuit of a fullway rectifier for better understanding. So this is the circuit representation of your fullway rectifier circuit, where the AC signal is being given to a transformer first. So here, as we are seeing it as step-down transformer, the circuit representation, we can classify whether it is a step-down or a step-up based on the windings. If the primary winding is greater than the secondary winding, then the particular transformer is said to be a step-down transformer.